believe we've got a great one in store today. We've got a team that makes it into the top 25. Now when you go on the road, that's when you prove you belong. As we'll see, the number 20 team in the country, the Louisville Cardinals. And the Pirates ready to get this thing started and open the season. He thought about bringing that out for a half second, but he'll take a knee and they'll bring it to the 25. The Cardinals offense will start this game off. And here comes their veteran leader. He has been through the battle, guys, and there are plenty of expectations this season.
Yeah, and there should be expectations. This guy's been around a long time, knows the systems, knows the players. Everybody's going to have to believe in him for this year to be a big success.
Yeah, David, there's just no substitution for experience, right? This guy has played so many snaps. He's seen it all. No doubt they need him to play at a high level.
They can really be aggressive after that last play at second and three. Running back searching for a hole. At the 45 on his way. They're ripping off chunks of yardage to get it to the 33. He's got 42 yards rushing for him now, and that is a way to make your presence felt in the early part of the season. To the ground with the back. Trying to pound their way forward, he picks up a couple to the 31. After picking up a couple at second and eight. Really important for a ranked team going into a hostile environment like this one not to give the underdog reason to believe.
Yes, reason to believe, and don't give the fans reason to get jacked up and excited. Come out early, be in a business mode mindset.
You gotta start fast, you gotta have a sense of urgency. You cannot come to an environment like this, because if you do and you make some mistakes, this crowd will pounce on you and seize momentum.
And the Cardinals are rolling down the field. It's a reverse. That one did not go well. Tackled in the backfield for a loss of six. They'll line up for a second down play.
Great discipline show by the defense. When your job's contained, you're supposed to contain the football. Not let your eyes deceive you. Ball starts to go away. Your job is to still contain the backside. Great job. Staying disciplined. Great win for the defense.
They'd love to pick up this third down and get a fresh set with first and goal. He'll keep it himself. Headed to the end zone. And he's sprinting. He'll take it all the way. Touchdown, Louisville. They're on the board first here in the season opener.
And that is the kind of drive to start a season that is going to put a smile on your head coach's face. They were just methodical in the way they marched down the field. Awesome execution. You cannot start the season any better than that right there.
He'll bring it back from inside his five. And the returner will be knocked down. Line gets set. First down. They'll give it to the back. May not look like a huge run, but they'll take it as it gets them up to the 24. 8-yard pickup on first down leaves them with second and short. They're looking for an advantage in the running game to the right. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three. Offense breaks the huddle. It's third down. Garcia to pass. And the Heat will get home. Quarterback goes down at the 17. The Pirates send out the punt unit.
Really impressed with how this team has seized momentum here, playing on the road in this hostile environment. Their offense gets it first. They march down the field. They put up some points. And here's the defense now on their first drive, getting a critical sack on third down.
They'll try the run. Shakes off the tackle.
And a nice second effort by the back to break a tackle. But how about those defensive backs willing to come up, stick their face in the fan, and make a tackle?
Those are the best run defenses, too, right? It's not just D-linemen and linebackers getting all the plays, but it's DBs that are willing to not just cover, but tackle backs in the open field.
The offense lines up at the 40. They've got a first down. Wide receiver coming across in motion. Here's the handoff. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Great job. grab by the whole defense, but how about the little bit of defensive back throwing his face in the fan? I ain't scared. I don't just cover guys. I make tackles.
Sweet cut there. And he's able to bounce off one tackle for a solid pickup. Let's see what they do on third down. From the gun, wants to pass. And the defense picks up a sack, getting the quarterback down at 44. The Cardinals will bring the punt team onto the field. And the offense sprung a big-time leak, and the quarterback went down.
And when you're throwing the football, you're trying to stop the best athletes in the world from getting to your quarterback. They're going to get there, they're pinning their ears back, get to the QB, get the sack.
Makes a man miss.
I know it's sexy to throw the football, but if you can pound it away and get these kind of gains, they will just add up. Bear the defense down, get first downs, and ultimately get some points.
Using the quick game. They make the stop, but not before he wraps up this first period with a huge game. That's the end of the quarter, and Louisville has the edge. We've put one in the books. Let's have a look at our game summary. Fresh set of downs after the completion. He'll come out throwing on first down. Got rid of it in a hurry, but he couldn't find his man. It's incomplete.
That's a throw the QB would like to have back. He just has to do a better job giving his receiver a chance to make the catch.
Takes the handoff. It's Harris. And the ball's loose in the backfield. How in the world did the offense retain possession? They recovered their own fumble, but now it's third down. He's looking downfield to throw. And he was hit just as he released it, and it falls to the turf. And the Pirates decide to punt it away.
Great job by the defense dialing up some pressure on third down. They hit the quarterback and force the incompletion.
The Louisville offense is headed back out on the field. They'll have another opportunity to extend this lead after punting last time, David.
And it's important to put that punt behind you. It's over. Let it go. Get back to what you were doing that built this lead.
Yeah, and defense, obviously, they won a few downs that last drive, so you got to put them on their heels here. Maybe mix up a few personnel groupings and try to show them some pictures they haven't seen yet.
Crosses the 30.
Well, in that down and distance, you're probably expecting them to throw it way down the field to get the first. Instead, they go push pass, and they did catch the defense off guard, and even though that was a big explosive play, David, they still didn't have enough yards to get it.
Well, it catch me off guard is relative. That's what you would say to the offensive player. I would say, listen, we're playing a little bit deeper because we're not going to give up the first down. We react to the short stuff, and obviously that's a quick, easy pass from the offense. Rally up, make the play, live to fight another down.
He gets it up to the 34-yard line before he stopped, and that's where the offense will set up shop. East Carolina has it back, and the Purple Pirate offense will go to work. Setting up the screen. Nice move to keep running. They finally get him stopped, but what a good job by that front wall to set up the screen and create some lanes for their running back. Reads it, fires complete. He's brought down quickly. Minimal gain there. Still a bit short of the first down. Picked up some yardage on the ground. Now here comes second down. Garcia wants to throw. Feeling some heat. Picks up the first down and gets down to avoid contact. The Pirates come to the line with a new set of downs.
He does a good job of dropping back, going through his progressions. Nothing there. What do I do? Go get some yards. Make it positive. Don't sit back in the pocket. Force something into a bad situation. Take a sack. Great job making something out of it.
This first half of offense won't go on the highlight reel so far. But starting to get things moving, it's first and 10. Second and 10 here. Here's a quick throw out to the left. And that defense is there to guide him out of bounds after a short gain. Ball's spotted at the 27. They're facing a third and long to try to keep their hopes of a touchdown alive. Got it on the outside. It's Harris. That's exactly what they told us they wanted to limit. Yards after the catch, and it pays off on this play.
And especially in these situations in third down when you know the ball's going to come out fast, understanding that, breaking on the football, going, making the tackle, forcing the field.
significant gap developed between these two teams right now.
No doubt. When your defense is scoring, your offense is scoring, good things happening for your ball club. This defense on point, reading their scouting report, making big plays.
East Carolina sending the offense back to work. They've stumbled a little bit out of the gate here, Jesse, finding themselves down by two scores.
Yeah, and their defense needs to help them out and get off the field, give them some more possessions. This offense didn't spend a lot of time on the field in the first quarter, David. I think they got to run the ball here and try to establish some rhythm.
They got to establish something, and you're right. You'll wear your defense out. Continue. You keep getting the football back to them, to the other offense. You're wearing your defense out. You have no shot to get back.
And this junior loves to show off that big arm. We've made our way to the two-minute warning, and now they'll try to at least cut a little something off of this lead before the break. Trying to find his man on first down. That one came in hot, and it's incomplete.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit, man, because they've come into this hostile environment. They've quieted the crowd down with some of the plays they're making. They've got a nice lead right here. They're making it hard.
And there was nowhere to go for this quarterback, and down he goes. The defense going to stop the clock with a timeout. They want to make sure they have everybody on the same page. They've made third down offense a key. It'll be tested on third and long from the 28. Garcia to pass. He's got the tight end. Quick timeout by the defense there, trying to make sure everyone has the same call.
You got to love that on defense. One of the most critical statistics out there is, how do you play on third down? How do you prevent the opponent from keeping drives alive? Right there, tackling the catch. You gave up the completion. Whoop-de-doo. You set up fourth and long. You're going to get the ball back. Go get some water and something.
The offense set for a first down play. He wastes no time and comes out throwing. Finds his man. It's Bell. Good job running that route to get past the sticks, because he got nothing after the catch. They've got a first and 10 at the 34. He's going to pass. Fires to the wideout. Just masterful working that sideline and getting the toe down for the catch. They are dialed in on this drive. A couple of chunk plays, and now they'll snap it on first down. Looking to move it through the air. Sure hands, it's Bell. And a big time grab there, knocked down immediately, but not before he gets it to the 40. And it's another first and 10 play. They want to just keep throwing it. Trying to make magic on the scramble. Got to protect the merchandise, gets down without taking a hit. Here comes the offense on second down. He's looking to throw, and that ball is picked off. Takes it the other way. He's inside the 40. The 20. Touchdown, East Carolina. The defense puts six on the board with a big-time interception return. And after the extra point, they cut the lead in half, down 14-7. They got the late touchdown on the board, now about to kick it away, and hoping the defense can keep them from answering. Let's see if he can make a play on the return. Bulldozes his way through. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Louisville has it back in the offense, coming out ready to attack. They've got some time to work with here, Jesse, and if they get a first down, they might really get aggressive.
I'd be aggressive right out of the gate. I'd be throwing for a first down. If I get it, then it's pedal to the metal. I'm in that two-minute mode to try to score a touchdown or get a field.
But I do think this is a situation where you also have to understand that I have the lead going into the half. I've got the momentum, so don't do anything stupid here.
Couldn't make the play on first down. They'll try it again. Second and 10 from the 27. They'll throw again after the incompletion. Got him downfield. Oh, the ball squirts out. Defense covering it up and not letting the offense get it back. It's a turnover.
It's a nice job by him making the catch, but guys, you got to secure the ball and put it away. The play's not over. Give the defender credit for knocking it loose, and the defense jumps on.
Going up top on first down. And he was hit just as he was releasing the pass, and pressure going right. Nobody open. He just throws it away, and it'll bring up second down. Time dwindling away as they try to put points on the board right before the half. Right back to the fires toward the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, ECU. They'll try to tack one more on their score. Smashes it through to the DAT. Quick work on. And the Cardinals will kick it away to crank up the second half. The returner will field it and try to do some business. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. East Carolina has it back, and the Purple Pirate offense will go to work. Trying to set the tone with the run. Get some work done there. Pick up a 4 to the 22.
I think one of the hardest things to do is stick to the run when it's not working. But it's those runs right there that are the reason why you have to do it, right? You can't get too one-dimensional. Keep slipping those runs in there. Keep getting a little bit of positive yardage. Next thing you know, you'll look up and you might break one of those if you let them in a good time.
Here on third down for this offense. Quarterback checking off. Out of the shotgun on third down. Fires to the big fella. Building momentum, picking up the chunky yardage, moving the chains out to the 34. And the Pirates will snap it on first and 10.
Well, I know the tight end did some good things after the catch, but got to give the quarterback credit, too, for the location of the throw. Because he put it out in front of his big man, he was able to make the catch and accelerate, creating some distance there between him and the defense.
Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. They'll run play action. Got out of trouble, got rid of it. And he throws down the gut of the defense. It's incomplete now.
Yeah, and sometimes the coverage is just great. And as a quarterback, you throw the football away or don't try to force it too tight into a window. And you just say, hey, defense won that rep. Good coverage.
Still on his feet at the 45. And he was loose and in the open field and on his way. A tremendous pickup on that one. The Pirates are flying down the field. Snap it to the back. And a nice run there before the defense finally makes the stop.
So we're talking about making it easy for an offensive coordinator to pick up a bunch of yards on first down, make that second down really, really manageable. That's a great job by the offense.
Caught behind the line. It's Bond. The defense wouldn't let him loose there, and it was a completion, but they lost yardage. About to snap it for the 8th time on this drive, and it's a 3rd down and 4. From the gun, wants to pass. Short throw is complete, and he'll grab it, step out of bounds, and pick up the 1st down. Now on 1st and 10, 26. They didn't get too greedy there. They knew what they needed, and he gets it just past the sticks.
Yeah, and I'd like to see the defense maybe be a little bit more aggressive, a little more in the face, because QBC is easy access. I'm going to throw the football. My receiver's got a little bit of space. He can get the first down. I'd like to see the defense make him work for it a little bit more.
Got some work to do after that last play, second and 13. Trying play action. Under heat, and he gets rid of it. Nowhere close on that one as he got drilled trying to deliver the football, and now they face third down. They've methodically worked it down the field. This the 11th play of the drive, but the defense can get off the field now. Quickly out to the tight end. The Cardinals' third down defense just not getting it done. Ever since they invented the forward pass, the tight ends have been running the drag and getting the first down.
I think it's because the tight end is so much versatility. You know, they can block and stay in the formation, or they can release and come out. But either way, if the quarterback's patient most of the time, that drag route's going to come in.
After losing a couple of yards, it's now second and 12 as they try to keep this drive moving. Out of the gun, the inside give. Tough running this deep in the red zone. He's got 4 down to the 11. Boy, they love to move the sticks here and take a shot at it on first and goal. On third and long, trying to have a big completion here. Escapes trouble. Couldn't find anybody open, just threw it away, and that's a smart move. You want to avoid the turnover, especially in the red zone. It'll be fourth down. Between the uprights, it's good.
And guys have to get field goal. Now they have the lead.
So after putting three on the board, the kickoff team is out there ready to boot it away. He'll bring it out. Pulled down at the 18, and the decision to bring it out of the end zone was not a good one. The Louisville offense is headed back out on the field. They're going to open this drive with a pass. Caught over the middle. It's Lacy. And a little more space. Open up that playbook even more as they pick up the first down out to the 30. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. To the air on first down. Down.
Yeah, and you've seen these curl routes. This is a timing route. Understand the ball's got to come out of my hand right when he hits the top of that curl. Nice job by the QB finding them. Nice catch.
Really nice stop there from this senior leader.
That's a really good job by the defense, wrapping them up, getting them on the ground. Take away that run game. Make them one-dimensional, put them in passing situations. Really good job by the defense.
Well, he was trying to do it all by himself. At the end of the day, it's a tackle.
The number of tackles he broke, at some point, somebody's got to get blocked to help the guy out a little bit.
Man, the defense was like a bunch of zombies on that last play. They just would not stop chasing that ball carrier.
Throws for the tight end. Fires into traffic. It's picked up. And he's brought down after the pick, but not before putting his offense in business.
Man, who says defensive backs don't have hands? Nice job. Swat it down, and you see them trying to catch it. It looks like they have two left hands. Defensive backs don't catch real well. Nice job breaking the football. Nice job securing the INT and actually catching it.
Guys, East Carolina carries the lead into the quarter break. They've built a cushion. They've got a nice lead. Now the task is finish the deal as you take a look at the third quarter stats. From the gun, running back on the move. And he's brought to the ground, but not before he gets enough for the first down. Here's his offense for the fresh set of downs.
It's a point in the game, I think, as a coaching staff, where you really challenge your offensive line to go win the football game, right? We've got a lead late. We're going to run the football. And the defense and everybody in the stadium knows that's what's going to happen. Can we run the ball down their throats and impose our will? That's what this offense right now is trying to do.
And he just overshot his man and threw it out of bounds, incomplete.
That's one the offense just needs to be able to hit, right? That's a completion they should be able to hit in their sleep. Receiver's got to do a better job.
Third and long, and he'll try to throw for it. And it's taken away by the defense, and they desperately needed that turnover. He couldn't quite get loose on that return, but he'd already made the play, and they've got it at the 35. Defense. They cannot believe it. A great play on the interception is wiped away with the roughing the passer call. And so the quarterback takes one for the team on the roughing the passer penalty, and it'll be first down.
This offense is in no hurry, right? Control the clock is priority number one. I'm going to run the football. I got the lead. I already got great field position, but I'm not interested in scoring right away.
Oh, no, the ball popped out. Defense on that loose ball. It'll be a turnover. First. Hang on here. The coach is calling timeout. He wants the officials to take another look. Thinks he's got a good shot at getting this one overturned. Might have to give that coach a flag and a whistle. He was right on in his view of the play, and the officials agree and overturn the call. Let's see what they've dialed up on third and long from the 22. He'll pull it down. Got some room, headed to the goal line. And he'll finish the run at the end zone. Touchdown, Purple Pirates. And the extra point extends the lead to double figures at 10. Quick strike offense on that three-play scoring drive. And it was capped with an explosive 22-yard run.
adversity after that last drive.
Yeah, clear the mechanism, move on. That's a part of it, right? If you're going to be a great player, you got to learn how to handle these mistakes and move on.
They'll throw it to the back on the screen. He's brought down. Solid pickup, but a little bit short of the first down. Now on third down for this offense.
Well, a nice gainer on that running back screen. Now, how about the offensive line getting downfield and getting blocks to really help out the back find some space to go to work?
They've got it to the 49-yard line, and they'll move the chains. And the Cardinals getting set on first and 10. Quarterback on the keeper. Picks up the first down, still moving. Open space at the 25. Ripped off a huge chunk play on that one as he gets the first down before he steps out of bounds. The Cardinals are moving quickly down the field. In the red area, it's Turner. A run up the middle is stuck for no gain. They got nothing on the last play. It's second and 10. He's looking to throw. A shot toward the end zone. And he throws his third pick of the day. His head has to be spinning. That's why you love veterans in this defense. They stay locked in on their rules, and he made the pick. From the gun, the ground game. Found a little bit of running room, knocked down at the 24 after a pickup of four.
Well, the offense has the lead, and we call this four-minute offense. This is a situation that teams around the country practice, having the lead late in the game and needing to ice it by running the football and throwing high-percentage passes.
He had all kinds of company as soon as he got it. He had to fight his way back just to get to the line of scrimmage. A third down try for the offense. Garcia to pass. Working that left side now. And he couldn't quite get to the marker, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. Perhaps emboldened by converting a fourth down earlier in the game, they'll try a second time. Jump the gun just a bit, and we've got a false start.
False start on offense.
So the decision has been made, and the coach will take the penalty. And the Pirates will call on their punt team. Fourth time tonight we've seen this guy come on to punt. He's got great speed. The Louisville offense is headed back out on the field. That last possession, a prime example, Jesse, of how things get condensed in the red zone.
Hard to throw when the windows are smaller, and that's what happens down near the goal line, David. But this quarterback here, just take accountability and ownership and come out here and lead your offense.
And move on. Like, we needed points. That's something that we can harp on. We'll watch the tape this week, but now it's time to move on. Let's get another drive going.
Comes out throwing on first down. Fires left. It's caught downfield. And they'll finally catch up to him, but not before a big chunk of yardage is picked up. We've reached the two-minute warning, and we see miracles in college football all of the time, and they could use one here. Looking to go up top on first down. Fires deep toward the end zone. And the throw and catch was good, but you got to do it in the field of play, and he couldn't quite keep that foot in bounds. So after reviewing the undisputable video evidence, the replay booth has decided to overturn the call. Lining up to add another. And the kick is good, but there is a penalty flag because he paid for making that kick. I think they're going to get him for roughing the kicker.
Roughing the kicker. Defense.
The officials offer the deal, and the coach accepts it. They will take the penalty. The kickoff team on the field, he ought to just boom this thing through the end zone with that extra 15 yards on the penalty. No shot at a return. It's out of the end zone, and it'll be a touchback. East Carolina sending the offense back to work. Okay, Jesse, this is a little bit of a tight spot. You'd love to be aggressive enough to get the first down, but you've got to take care of the ball first.
No doubt. I was going to say, ball security is at a premium. You cannot turn the football over at this point. The defense has three timeouts left, David, so probably conservative play calling here. You're expecting them to try to run to ice this game.
Conservative, I know they're going to be aggressive, but I also know that one first down.
And the pressure will get there. The sack. Down he goes in the waning moments. That could be a costly play. This defense has kept them backed up. Now one more stop, and they can get off the field on third and long. Looking downfield, and he needs a bunch. Pulls it in. It's right. Fights off the defender. And he's not going to make it. The defense denying him the first down. Defense uses a timeout quickly, trying to get that ball back and preserve time for their offense. They have the lead in a one-possession game, but they're thinking deliver the knockout blow, but this carries big-time risk on fourth down. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. It's incomplete, and they desperately needed to keep that drive going, and they couldn't make the connection. Couldn't ask for better field position for this offense. Grabbed in the middle. It's Bell. And they'll finally get him down after a terrific pickup. They're in the red zone. First and 10 from the 20. He's looking to throw it. Gets it out quickly. And he runs through one tackle and picks up a few. Operating in the red zone here on second down. Scanning the field. It's Shuck. Let's it go to the end zone. And it's picked off for the fourth time today. And they'll close in on him after a good return on the interception.
That might be the nail in the coffin, fellas. This offense, they're trying to get back in the game. You're having to be aggressive. You're now going to have to start taking chances. An errant throw ends up in the hands of the defense, and I think that's all she wrote.
The rankings, the odds makers, everything indicated that these guys had a big hill to climb. But they climbed it, they got to the top, and they get a landmark win.
And we know coaching staffs always do a great job trying to motivate their own guys and get them ready to play a ranked opponent. But David, to me, it looked like this team just wanted it more. They came out, they were the more physical team, and they did what they had to do at the end of the day to get this win.
And how do you gain respect?